Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another War Thunder development blog video. I'm not exactly sure if this vehicle's available to everyone yet. I would assume that it is, but I don't know for sure. I know that since the way that they're doing the introduction of France, they're doing it the way where people who purchase the pre-order packs get full access to the entire tech tree, while other players only get access to like the first couple vehicles, and they have to wait a few days before they get another new vehicle to unlock, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So I don't know if this is. Oh, it says right freaking here. So the F-222-2 and the D-501, which we're looking at here, are now available for testers of the French aviation. So this one will just be titled a development blog, and not an upcoming content. This is one of the Tier 1 French fighter aircraft that might look very weak, but trust me, this thing is fucking badass. At least in arcade battles, as far as I'm aware. I'm not so sure about realistic. Somebody might have to tell me about that one. I believe this isn't the reserve aircraft. This is actually the one you get after the reserve D plane. And, as the development blog states, at the time of their introduction of service, or to service, aircraft of the D-500 series were among the most advanced in the world. Wow. They certainly look like it. However, rapid advancements in aircraft development quickly rendered the D-500 series obsolete as more and more technologically advanced aircraft made their appearance. Meet one of the versions of the series, the D-501, or D-501, which, as far as I believe, has a 20 mm cannon in the nose at like battle rating 1.3. What the hell? Okay, here's a little bit of history on the aircraft if you want to see a little bit more in-depth stuff about it. It's very pretty looking, actually. You can see the camouflage paint scheme here that this plane actually has. Now, I know that there's also a D series aircraft premium, Tier 1. Not sure if this is the same one because I think that one actually looks different and handles a little differently. Anywho, in War Thunder, the D-501 will receive the chance to go up against contemporary designs of other nations in low-ranked battles, allowing the aircraft to make full use of its advanced design features. Although it may not seem like it, the D-501 combines several traits that many pilots appreciate in a small, compact package. Its 690 horsepower engine allows it to reach a respectable maximum speed of 367 kilometers an hour at medium altitudes, whilst the lightweight fuselage ensures excellent maneuverability and handling. And it so far has not mentioned anything about the cannon that this thing carries. Besides excellent handling, pilots of the D-501 can also make deadly use of the aircraft's offensive armaments, consisting of a 20 mm cannon and two low-caliber machine guns mounted underneath the wings. For most opponents of the D-501 will or for most opponents the D-501 will meet in combat, a single quick burst will be more than enough to send the opponent spiraling to the ground, which is just awesome. In War Thunder Update 1.73, the D-501 is added as rank 1 fighter aircraft of the French aviation tech tree. And here we've got a few more screenshots of it. So very pretty looking aircraft, that's for damn sure. It's got that unique design to it that the parasol fighter had, which is why I think I like how this thing looks, because it's something that we really haven't seen anything like this on any other tech tree, at least as far as I can remember. I could be wrong about that. But even then, a battle rating, I think 1.3 aircraft that has two machine guns and a cannon. I know we've gotten aircraft, low battle rating like that before with cannon and stuff, but it's just so nice to see more because they're so freaking ridiculous in low tier arcade battles, especially if you wait. Because right now, everybody's trying to play France, so it's kind of hard to enjoy the French aircraft to their fullest when everybody's trying to freaking play them. So in a few weeks, a month or two, come back to it and everybody's, it's all back to normal mostly. You jump into this thing, you're going to be fighting some new players. You're going to be fighting lots of new players. This thing is going to be an ultimate wrecker of new players. I mean, when you get into a normal reserve aircraft and rack up 10, 15, 20 kills because you're fighting inexperienced players and it's probably not fun for them, imagine what you can do when you have a cannon, even though it has not that much ammunition, that's for sure. But still, I don't know. I just love how this thing is. And it's not like the HS9 or whatever it's called, the Tier 1 premium that the French have, which has two cannons, because that only has 60 rounds, 30 rounds per cannon. Okay, that's a little different because this one has a single cannon, sure, but it also has two machine guns to fall back on if its cannon runs out. So you're using those machine guns while your cannon is reloading, and then by the time your machine guns are down, depending on your crew skill or depending on what type of heated battle you're in, you've got your cannon back up to start destroying planes. I mean, hell, even a small burst of light machine gun bullets at this tier can obliterate some of the tier one planes that you fight against, like the biplanes and stuff. So imagine what it's going to do when you shoot a cannon at them. Anyways, that's going to be the end for the D501. If you've already flown it, feel free to let me know your opinions on it in the comments below, or if you're not working on the French just yet but will be at a later date, this is probably something you'll want to look forward to if you're a fighter pilot and are going to be playing the low tier battles, or if you took advantage of the times 5 when it was available and got your first victory with the SO8000 in France and made yourself between 40,000 and 68,000 RP, because holy shit, and ground out all of Tier 1 and Tier 2 in one go. Yeah, crazy, I know, right? Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder development blog slash upcoming content video.